Hey guys, and welcome back. We are just about to go finish this section of the planet quest for Nar Shaddaa. We are going to explore Revan's vault, which is quite exciting. We get to find out a bit more about Revan and the Infinite Engine. So, let's just get things in the way.
Okay.
Let's kill them all. Oh, such a weird sound. It was like a monkey. Okay, down in the lift. Infinite Engine, here we come. The abandoned factory. Oh, I was about to say, that was huge. This isn't... Is it story locked? Kill some droids. Right, so we need to kill 15 droids. I reckon we do this. Let's just make sure that we get as much level prowess as we can. That's 6. Space 9. Oh, 10. 10. 10's good. And this will make 12 or 13. And this makes everything. And done. I just didn't want to do that big baddie for no reason. This is a recording thing that we can find out a bit more about Revan and the Infinite Engine. I hate doing it, but for the purposes of this let's play, let's find out as much information as we can. Interesting. Oh, is that a new belt? Nope. I think this has got the first piece of the holo recording. Yep, right there. You can see it does come up on the map as like a little normal side quest thing. So we'll just do this.
Manub Merakanaja. Kinamabam. Yak Manala. Meraka gemyam amgam nemnu namgam pak unaki jak memgam gangi nina gegwan amnerna hanak kamperem ganyam bajiyang manik hekum bokam.
That alien race basically looks like one of the character artists decided to just how to fuck up a character with humanoid features as much as possible. That thing is terrifying to look at. And now the next Infinite Engine little holo recording is that way. Oh, there it is. It's over there. Bit harder to kill. But no real match for us. Next recording, please.
Naya na rankam. Kala ama mani mami. Lebig bak. Bimka naya nugan. Ejinim naya lak umnan mege. Mem amgab kugab. Kramanik, Unka kiga mayamak, nakag agib kikbenabab, Nea agam berakaki. Kam inu nemuk. Naja naya akam menig miraka. Miraka karam kara. Ninyamak oramag yang megig. Miraka kemyam amgam nemnu. Namgam pak unaki jak.
So basically, this machine keeps this race of people alive. So without it, they can't see, they can't eat. It's actually kind of freaky. No, it automatically triggers if I go too close to it. So I'm just going to go around as tightly as possible so that we can get the last recording. Alright, and here's the last one.
Bi ambun, jirami nika pula kemgam. Naya na rankam. Kala ama mani mami, libig bak. Kala jiwa nimok, pemgam niyama naya aigam. Chukagi ne paninu, hamkam pina pek nemu kemgam. Kamperem ganyam bajiyang, manik hikum bukam. Kama ne mega, nagaka? Manalak laki na bi nek kemeraka.
Okay. I didn't really tell us anything vitally important other than that they know that someday someone's going to come for the machine. Which, woo, their lucky day, we are. And here they are. All around this machine thing.
Nenua imuk. Beraka karam kara. En ninyamak oramag yang megig.
Revan brought you people here centuries ago. How are you still alive?
Kala jiwa nimok. Ebemgam nyama naya aigam. Yang perlu amka. Kalima naya kira. Nebua ribok. Naya naramkam. Kala ama mani mami. Lebig bak.
Power like that belongs in the hands of the Empire. Step aside.
Nulilak apa jam kamgram. Amka nem nang nemua inuk. Manub meraka naja. Kinamabam. Yak manala. Chukagi ne paninu. Amkam pina pek nemu kemgram.
I'm not leaving here without that machine.
Meraka kemyam amgam nemnu. Namgam pak unaki jak.
Oh, his face is terrifying. And he's dead. Right, so we've done that. Let's go back to General Colvin in the Imperial Special Ops Center. So we basically just killed a race of people for a machine that we could have grown ourselves, give or take. Like, it would take centuries, we could have done it.
I raided Darth Revan's complex. Here's what I found.
I can feel it humming with power. What is it? Some sort of device?
I found this machine with the descendants of Revan's alien slaves. It furnished everything they needed to survive.
Including those impossible assassin droids and turrets, presumably. Those descendants of Revan's slaves you mentioned. Are the aliens still alive?
The ones I didn't kill won't survive without this machine.
Excellent. I despise loose ends. The Emperor will be pleased. You've done a commendable job. I'll have this machine transported to Dromund Kaas for study. With any luck, we can put it to good use.
I suspect that technology will be of great value to the Empire.
I've just received a request for assistance from my colleague Major Damaris in network access. If you visit that sector, he could use you.
Awesome, and now we've gotten the hint to go to the final sector. We've got some new gloves, which haven't really done a lot. They're a bit plainer than the last ones. We are going to go to the... Oh, man. Quick travel. It's too long. Can't bother to speed this up, so we're going to... Oh, the speeder is literally just around the corner, so we'll just travel to the speeder and then go to the spaceport. I really want to be able to show you guys as much of the outside and the exterior of Nar Shaddaa as possible, because it is stunning. It's one of the few city planets besides... I think Nar Shaddaa is beautiful just because it's neon wonderland, but Corellia is the city planet that I would say is the most impressive.
Planets are currently open for business.
Corellia is literally the last planet we will go to in the class story for everything, I think. I think all... it may not be where all class stories end, but it is the last planet that you visit in terms of like planet quests and all this sort of stuff. That's not for a long way off yet. Since we're still in chapter one, I think. It doesn't say here, which is really quite annoying. It's one thing that I wish this game had was some sort of... and it might do. I might just be being silly and like not being able to find it. But I would really like somewhere where it tells me everything that I've already done. This have the chapters of the expansion stuff, so you can read what the next parts are on those. But they don't have it for the class quests, which I find annoying. When you first log into the game, after you've been away, it will tell you a quick summary of what you're doing, which I'd rather not keep doing in our Let's Play, but that is something that you can do. And it helps me actually before I start recording an episode just to sort of catch up mentally with what we've already done and what we're going to be doing. They need it written down somewhere. They need this chapters to include the prologue all through to chapter 3. It just makes more sense.
I want all of the data on Eidolon Security's encryption programs, now! You're seconds away from a messy death. Only one way to find out. This will be our only meeting.
No loose ends. Right, now we can go speak to Gellerin. Oh, you know what, this time I am so quick travelling to the cantina. Because it takes so long to travel everywhere. I'm hoping that we can finish Nar Shaddaa in this episode. I'm thinking it should be possible. We've only got one more area to do, and we did two areas in the last episode, so this is all very doable. If the screen's not black.
Careful.
Oh, there was a bit of a bug there.
I'm back with Z's codes.
Ha! Wish I could have seen the look on Z's face. Anuli, we good?
Everything looks legit. Beautiful work. Z's code is like music.
Yeah, whatever. Isolate the ones we'll need and hand the pad back to our hunter friend here.
Eidolon Security's transceiver codes are marked. Easy to spot. they'll disable the encryption programs. No problem.
And that helps how?
They're gonna get you access to all of Eidolon Security's confidential files. Once we get those, the Eidolon's personal business will be everybody's business. Ha! Eat that, you ganks! Ha! Okay, so on to phase two of our plan to scrag Eidolon Security's rep and drive their clients away. Anuli?
Gotta access Eidolon Security's data transceivers. Input these codes, then slice into Eidolon's network, download their files.
Here's a holonet transmitter. Once you've accessed Eidolon's network, put this on the transceiver. It'll let Anuli upload the file straight to the holonet.
Eidolon Security's entire database is on the holonet. That's bad. Real bad. For them.
The transceivers are in the network access sector. Security's gonna be tight. And the Eidolon will have his best men protecting those transceivers. Feel free to kill as many as you want.
Ooh, did we level up? Level 26. We've got a new... Oof, I don't like the cape. That is not good. Oh my god, we look ridiculous. Okay. Let's just talk to Senya. Have you given me anything? Okay, what is this? Grant 6 seconds of immunity from movement impairing effects. See, these sort of things I know I'm not going to use. I might just sort of situate some of these things. So I don't use... This is fire dart detonite after several seconds. I'm just going to put the ones I do use up here. I like those there because I know which things these are. Okay, I don't... What is this? Hurls a thermal detonator. We like that. I do use these, but I just don't use them enough. This is an incapacitating effect. That is disabling shot. That's this. Venting heat. That's sort of like a buff thing. That takes forever to charge. And so does that. Cool, so I think we're finished. That's enough. I hate our outfit. So now we get to go to network access. God, this could take forever. Okay, I'm gonna speed this up for you guys. And here we come at our final destination of this map. I don't remember how big this place is, but I think it is relatively large. Oh no, it's not that bad. It's probably one of... Ah no, it's not that bad. We'll go to the Imperial Data Center first and get our quest from Major Damaris. Damaris? I'm going to say Damaris. Sounds more likely.
Halt! I am Major Damaris with the Imperial Ministry of War. The Empire is contracting you for a dangerous mission, Bounty Hunter. Starting immediately.
What's this got to do with that hut?
My associate, Kabura the Hut. His cartel operates the Network Access District, the central hub for the entire galactic holonet. This is a major threat to Imperial security. Breaching the Hutt's defenses and assuming this level of control should have been impossible. We need you to investigate. Immediately.
I'll be glad to find the culprit for you, Major.
Your skills make you uniquely suited to deal with this. The main data center is almost impenetrable. A series of well-guarded consoles is spread throughout network access, each with its own time-sensitive code. Get all the codes, then hurry to the data center. Once you reach the data center access terminal with all of the timed codes, we'll contact you with further instructions. Is that clear?
Get the codes, blast the consoles. Call you when I'm there.
Best of luck.
Okay, so now we know what to do for our planet quest. Let's head back. Let's get started. some idle players just hanging about. Right, we're about halfway through the episode, and I feel fairly confident that we can finish everything that we need to do in this episode. It'd be nice to be able to find out where we're going next as well, though I'm not holding out hope for that. So we pretty much want to go straight ahead to download a master code, I think. These are all friendlies, I don't have to worry about killing these people. Someone has been by killing things, except for the people that I need them to kill. Oh, does that even get him? Nope. Oh, I feel so much cleaner here now. Let's download the data. Or the master code. Okay. Let's move on. Let's kill lots and lots and lots. Let's try and get some really good XP with this. I'm not gonna defeat the unnecessarily difficult ones. Oh, this is one. All done. That was access code Auric. Now we're doing access code Besh. Which is dead set ahead. Let's just speed up a bit. Right, it's right inside this difficult droid. Ooh.
Bomb on the way.
Oh, we haven't done this one yet. It's basically a bomb. Yes. Next one is just around the corner. Access code Garrick. Oh, he wants us to go back to... Oh, let's go to access data terminal. That water doesn't look very healthy. I'm going to jump into it anyway. Oof. There it is.
You've input the codes. Excellent. Kabora.
Rundi Kaba, Kyotopa, Bubanda Bakamur Sanita.
Then this is it. Hurry into the data center, locate the saboteur, and eliminate him.
I'll take care of it.
Be ready for anything. Damaris out.
Awesome. And we've got some new boots. Oh, thank God. I actually like those boots. And are we defeating people? Oh, I didn't even see them. Yes, bonuses. I like these. Kill all of these. And through the door, please.
You have arrived. I am Axis, the Knowledge Seeking. You see, I am completely untouchable. We will now come to an arrangement that benefits us both.
The guy who hired me didn't seem interested in any arrangements.
You will accept the arrangement. It is the only rational outcome. I am learning all things, all information, all secrets, all data in the galaxy. I will gladly relay all I learned to your empire. But I must remain here. That is the arrangement you are going to accept. I survive, and the Empire gains knowledge and advantage.
What if I don't agree to the arrangement?
Possible. The benefit is too great, therefore you will not refuse it. The arrangement depends on secrecy. The Huts will not tolerate my presence here. Therefore, they must believe I have been killed. Large generators power this facility. You will overload all but the backup. The facility will be devastated, and I will appear to have been killed.
I came to kill you, and I never leave a mission half done.
Release your illusions. There is no benefit to killing me, and so long as my shields remain, it cannot be done. You will overload all of the primary generators, leaving the backup for me, and in return, I serve your empire. It is simple. The generators are well defended. Tread carefully, and be prepared for the rewards of infinite knowledge.
He's very presumptuous, isn't he? Get both of them in the circle. Almost shot him off. I'm trying to get to 50. Oh, we've done 50k, so now I can actually buy the galaxy map upgrade. But the only problem is that it will only leave me with 1,000 credits, which isn't very clever. So I'm not going to do that. Ah, shot him off. Also, I've done the bonus. Mako is trying to get me killed. What the fuck are you doing, Mako? Come here. Why do I have to heal myself? You are not seriously making me heal myself. What's wrong with you? Here she comes. It's because I'm still in combat. How am I still in combat?
Okay.
Oh well. Sometimes if you shoot enemies off the surface, things can get a little buggy. I'm hoping that I haven't just sort of ruined everything. Mako! Come here!
Right behind you.
The further away we go, it will slowly disappear. Would you heal me? Okay. Oh, it's because it thinks we're in combat. It's gonna make my speed super slow. We're like miles away from the
Behind you.
Awesome, that bomb does decent damage. Well, looks like we're out of combat now. It's finally decided. Oh wait, you're not needed in combat. Almost final parts. last couple of people to kill. Oh, I didn't need to do that. Access backup generator. Now this is where we make a choice. Welcome to the generator command console system interface. Okay. And
this should keep the Empire's secrets secure.
Evacuate immediately. And handily, there is an elevator right here. I mean, a lift. Level one, please. Jesus Christ. And we are out of here. Let's access the data terminal.
This is Major Damaros. We registered a large explosion inside the data center. Has the target been eliminated?
I followed your instructions.
Excellent. We're fortunate you could take part in the mission. Kabura informs me that the hut's backup systems are rerouting data successfully. The Holonet survives for another day. I must report to the Minister of War. Your assistance in this matter will not be forgotten. Damaros out.
Awesome. We've got a hat, which we will not be putting on, but, I mean, aesthetically. Now, we are cutting it fine with this episode, because I don't know how long this Eidolon shit's going to take, but we are going to try, because I want to try and get everything finished in this for Nar Shaddaa in this episode. So we're just going to motor ahead and access the Holonet transceiver through that door there, and hopefully not aggro anything on the way there. Alright, I'm just going to come out with speed just in case I need Mako with me. Anything here to kill? Let's shoot you back. Okay, so we've got 3 out of 10, so we know it's not going to be a long battle. Right, 5 down, 5 to go. Let's just get these bozos over here. Some over here. And that is done. I want to defeat the Eidolon already. Where is the receiver? Oh, it's there. Mako! You are useless, apparently, Mako. Okay, save that for the Eidolon. Ooh, green. No. Nope, not worth it. Okay.
Okay, that should take care of Z's encryption programs. Transmitter's in place. Let me slice into Eidolon's network. Well, this is tough. Nuli wasn't kidding. The Eidolon's holonet guys know their stuff.
It's professional, that's for sure. Lucky we're better.
Looks like their clients are getting their money's worth. Come on. Come on. I'm in. I'll contact Nuli. Nuli, are you getting this? That's quite a data stream, huh?
Beautiful. All these work. Symphony of math. Downloading the files onto the holonet now. Stand by.
Let's get out of here before more of the Eidolon's mercs show up. They're way too good with those blasters.
Who put you up to this? Was it the cartel?
Professionals don't divulge contacts. You understand.
Doesn't matter. We'll get the intel one way or another.
Eliminate the threat! Now!
Oh, they want to play. Oh, that's a bug. Oh, why are we getting a personal holo?
He's found us! It's too late! He's here! He found us!
Get out of there! Move it!
Nowhere to run! He'll find you! He always finds you! We're all dead! Get away! Get away from me! No! No! Ah! Ah!
We have to get there! We have to save him!
Time to take out the Eidolon.
We're coming, Anuli.
I think Anuli's dead. I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty sure he's dead. I'm just gonna assume it's in the Slippery Slopes Cantina, so it's just waypoint there. I mean, quick travel. I'm so used to saying waypoint from Guild Wars 2 that I just automatically say waypoint. I need to start thinking Star Wars. Quick travel. It's doing that black
Nuli.
Thing.
Okay. Oh no. Oh no.
The Eidolon may still be here.
Right. Okay. I'm sorry.
Can you tell what killed Anuli?
I can't really tell. The look on his face. What was that?
Where are they? They just keep appearing! Come on, get me to 28-7. Oh, green! We like green! Oh, it's a skirt! Good thing that is not... Not a good defense.
What were those things? I can't believe he's gone. I never should have left him. It's all my fault. Again.
We can still avenge him.
Yes. I want to make Eidolon pay. Look, the holocommunicator on Galarin's desk is blinking. Maybe he's still alive, sending us a message.
Well, I highly doubt it, but let's do it anyway.
Oh, there you are. It's been a bit of a challenge tracking you down. I figured you for a rogue agent, but the question was, for whom? I should have known. Glaren's the only one stupid enough to do this.
Figured you'd be taller, or a cyborg or something.
I'm small enough to slip through a crack in a door, and large enough to loom over all of Nar Shaddaa. I must admit, I'm rather impressed that one person could be responsible for so much damage. If you wish to meet me, come to these coordinates. I'll be sitting right here, waiting for you. Of course, the second you step out of the door, you're dead. Shame, really, since our confrontation would have been most exhilarating.
Now you'll get to see what bounty hunters are all about.
You don't know how much I want that to be true. Well, Hunter, I'm sad to say this is goodbye.
Well, here we go. Let's be careful with this crazy.
Woo, woo, woo. And we've leveled up. Oh no, that didn't do us any favors. Okay, 27. I'm not going to bother with Zanya right now. I'm not going to bother with our ability trainer. Okay, so where does it want us to go? Yeah, no, just look. Okay. Right, I'll speed this up for you guys. Okay, and now we are in... Killing Eidolon's guards. Now, we are going to go over time, but it seems a bit silly to stop now. It's only... the bonus is only 10, so it can't be that long. Look, we're so over-leveled that it's put us down to 26 from 27. That's where you should always aim to be. Oh, it's got us on this bloody slow thing. Oh, almost. Almost! Okay, finished the bonus. Now we're going to try and avoid all combat so that we can just get this finished. Where is the Eidolon? There he is.
Unbelievable. Here you stand. Alive. Who are you, and why are you doing this?
I'm not here to talk to you.
Fair enough. It was a pleasure to meet you. Opponents like you are very rare and precious. I regret having to kill you.
Wait, I've got a priority message from Solash. He's another cartel lieutenant. He's offering a huge bounty if you bring him the Eidolon, alive.
The Hutts want to do terrible things to you.
Oh, come now. You'll never claim that bounty. But then, if we don't have our dreams, what do we have? Come. It's time to die.
Do you think so? Really? Where did he fucking vanish to? Right, I'm just gonna have to do slow burns. Long-lasting things. Oh, I need to vent. Good to do when he's not. Stop trying to Cairo freeze me. Yes.
Well, what are you waiting for? You've done it. You've beaten me. Finish it now, and be remembered forever as the hunter who killed the Eidolon.
I have other plans for you.
Handing me over to the cartel is the act of a brutish thug. You're better than that. Listen to me. I'm appealing to your sense of honor as an equal. Don't hand me over to the cartel. Kill me now. I deserve that much.
You're just another job.
You can't do this. I'm the Eidolon.
I'll contact Solash and tell him to meet us at the spaceport. We can deliver the Eidolon and collect the bounty.
Oh my god! We are almost finished. I'm doing all of this. I'm going to the spaceport. We are going to complete this planet. I don't care if we're already like 45 minutes in. We're finishing it. Come on. Speed, speed, speed. I think that was quite a good story. I think both the class and the planet stories were quite good on this planet.
I received your message. My name is Solash. Do you have the Eidolon?
Do you have my money?
Of course. The cartel always honors its bounties. I must ask, why have you succeeded where so many others have failed so miserably? Who exactly are you?
I'm just a bounty hunter.
A rather exceptional one, I'd say. The cartel will be watching your career with great interest. I have your promised bounty, and well-deserved, too. Please consider spending some of it in our wonderful casinos. Good day, Hunter.
And we're done. Now, I think we'll leave it here, and the next thing that you guys will see will be us in our ship. So, thank you very much for watching.